Okay, today we will discuss about application layer protocols. So one of the most popular frequently used protocol is firewall protocol. So here we will go through the various modes and commands as well as replies of FTP, then TFTP and the comparison between FTP and TFTP. Now all of you know that the main purpose of computer network is basically to transfer data, share resources, provide backup whenever and wherever required, and remote login. So file transfer is also a very common operation which we need to do. We require two types of protocols for transferring files. In general, they are used. That is, one is FTP, file transfer protocol, is a standard mechanism provided by TCP/IP for copying file from one host to another. And another one is TFTP. So we will comment on that also. There are some problems associated with file transfer mechanism from one machine to another, which can be as follows. That is, say for example, two systems may have different ways to represent data, different forms they might have followed, and that is a presentation of data. And then the systems may have different directory structure. That is also very, very important thing. So it is necessary for FTP to solve all these problems while transferring the data, to consider them. For transferring file, it establishes two connections between hosts. One connection is used for data transfer and another connection is used for control information. So separation of commands and data transfer makes FTP more efficient. Now it is a standard mechanism. So definitely between two systems, it is going to be carried out. Now as a prerequisite, it is application layer protocol. So which moves files between local and remote file systems. So it runs on the top of TCP, like HTTP. To transfer a file, two TCP connections are used by FTP in parallel, control connection and data connection. So this is a general view. So there is a TCP/IP, control connection and data connection, control process, data transfer process, that is a server, and a disk is going to maintain all that. And at the client side also, there is a user interface, control process and data transfer process. So the TCP/IP is, that is a transport layer protocol, is looking after all these activities. Now what is a control connection? Basically for sending control information like user identification, then password, commands to change the remote directory, commands to retrieve and store files. So FTP makes use of control connection. The control connection is initiated on port number 21. And as far as data connection is considered, then it is nothing but FTP makes use of data connection on the port number 20. It sends the control information out of band as it uses separate control connection. Some protocols send their request and response header lines, the data in the same TCP connection. For this reason, they are said to send their control information in band. HTTP and SMTP are some of such protocols. So data connection is also very, very important part of all this. So there is a, there may be a server client communication going on, and some creation of such commands and responses is carried out. Similar to Telnet and SMTP, FTP communicates across the control connection. It uses NVT ASCII character set for communication, and communication is normally done using commands and responses. Only one command or one response is sent at a time during the control connection. Each command or response is only one short line, so we need not have to worry about the file format or file structure. Every line is terminated with two characters, that is carriage return and line fill. Now as far as the sessions are established, so accordingly one by one it is going to transfer the command, and accordingly the process will be carried out. It needs to maintain a state about its user throughout the session. So this is also very important. As far as HTTP is considered, it is stateless. It does not have to keep track of any user state, but FTP has to do that. So that is again one more difference. As far as communication is considered, it is following FTP. As far as a protocol, it follows file types. So like it can use ASCII file. So text files are by default transferred using ASCII format. Then it can use EBCDIC file. So if one or both ends of the connection use EBCDIC encoding, the file can be transferred using EBCDIC encoding. Then it can use image file. This is default format of transferring binary files. Now it uses four types of structures. So there is a data structure. FTP allows three types of data structures. So that is file structure. The file has no structure. It is continuous stream of bytes as we can use anytime, anywhere. Then the record structure. There is a file made up of sequential records. And page structure. The file is divided into pages and it is made up of independent, maybe indexed pages. And each page is having page number or page header. It may be there. And page can be accessed randomly or sequentially. As far as transmission modes are considered, FTP uses three transmission modes. First one is stream mode. Here data is transferred in continuous stream or bytes. Then block mode. Here data is transferred in the form of blocks. And the compressed mode. Here the data is transferred. But before that, run length encoding is done. And run length encoding is going to help for the compression of the data. Then as far as file transfer, one more thing, that is takes place over data connection associated with control connection, no doubt. But for retrieving of a file is copied from server to the client, and for storing purpose, a file can be copied from client to server. Server sends a list of directory or file names to the client. FTP treats such a list of a directory as a file, and the file transfer is carried out. Now we will go through the FTP commands. So it creates a control connection between client and control process and server control process. During this communication, commands are sent from the client to the server and responses are sent from the server to the client. FTP commands are roughly divided into six groups. Like one is access group. There are some commands like user, pass, then ACCT, reinitialization, quit, abort. Some of the commands just I have listed here. And then there is a second category like file management. So there are also some of the commands. Then there is a data formatting commands, port defining commands, file transferring commands, and some of them are miscellaneous commands. So some of them I've just taken here. For example, so it is a user command. This command sends the user identification to the server. Pass command, this sends the user password to the server. CWD command, this allows the user to work with different directory or data set for file storage or retrieval without altering his login or accounting information. Then there is RMD command. This command causes data removal, that is directory specified in the path name to be removed as a directory. Then MKD. So MKD is create new directory, or it is a make. So this command causes the directory specified in the path name to be created. It is a making of the directory. Then PWD, it is nothing but display, just so display name of the current or present work directory. So this is the present work directory display. So it is going to return that. Then there is RETR. So RETR is retrieve files. So this command causes a remote host to initiate a data connection and to send the requested file over the data connection. Then STOR, it is store files. So files are transferred from client to server, so directly into the current directory to the remote host also. So list sends a request to display the list of all files present in the directory. Then ABOR, it is used for abort operation, that is abort the previous command, tells the server to abort the previous FTP service command and any associated transfer of data. Then quit. This is going to terminate, so it terminates user, and if file transfer is not in progress, the server closes the control connection. Then there are even few more commands like help, ask information about the server, or noop, that is check if server is alive, that is kind of no operation. Then site is a command, then specify the site specific commands. Then there is like SYST. It asks about the operating system used by the server, which exactly operating system server is using. Then there is a STAT, so status of the file it will return. Then there is STOU, so similar to a store, except that the file name will be unique in the directory. Then ALLO, so allocate the storage space for the files at the server. Then there are some of the replies also. Even FTP is going to give reply. So under number, that is 200 command okay, 530 not logged in, 331 username okay, need a password, 225 data connection open, no transfer in progress, 221 service closing control connection, then 551 it is requested, action aborted, page type unknown. When 502 command not implemented, 503 band sequence of commands, 504 command not implemented for that particular parameter. Then we'll brief out about tribal file transfer protocol, that is TFTP. It is also file transfer protocol without sophisticated features of FTP. It is good for simple transfer such as during boot time. It uses UDP as a transport layer protocol. Errors in the transmission like lost packet, checksum error must be handled by the TFTP server. It uses only one connection through well-known port number of 69. TFTP uses a simple lockstep protocol. Each data packet needs to be acknowledged. So it's a reliable one. The throughput is limited. It was first time defined in 1980. Functionally a very basic form of FTP. Then the modes available in TFTP are NetASCII, 8-bit ASCII. There is Octanet. This replaces the binary mode of previous version of this document, and the mail is NetASCII characters sent to user rather than file. As far as TFTP is considered, then we'll brief out about the simple words, some sort of a kind of operation of TFTP. So it begins with a request or read or a write kind of operation, which also server serves to request a connection. If the server grants the request, then connection is opened and the file is sent in fixed length. The block length is of 512, that is 512 bytes. A data packet of less than 512 bytes signals termination of the transfer. It is not going to consider. Each data packet contains one block of data and must be acknowledged by acknowledgement packet before the next packet comes. If packet gets lost in the network, then the intended recipient will time out and may retransmit last packet, maybe data or acknowledgement. Then the sender has to keep just one packet on hand and or retransmission, since lockstep acknowledgement guarantees that all older packets have been received. One sends data and receives acknowledgements, the other sends acknowledgements and receives data. Now, as far as uses are considered, TFTP is used to read files from or write files to remote server. Then TFTP, due to lack of security, it is dangerous over the open internet. Thus, TFTP is generally only used on private local networks. Some of the drawbacks here we can list out about TFTP. So that is, TFTP cannot list directory contents. TFTP cannot list directory contents. Remember this. TFTP has no authentication or kind of an encryption mechanism specifically followed. TFTP allows big data packets which may burst and cause delay in transmission. Definitely it is hazardous, and TFTP cannot download files larger than 1 terabyte. So size of 1 terabyte is a maximum limit for file transfer operation in case of TFTP. Now we will in brief some sort of a comparison we'll do between FTP and TFTP. Based on operation, both are doing the same, transferring files. As far as authentication is considered, in FTP authentication is present, in TFTP it is not authenticated. Control and data, in FTP it is separated, in TFTP it is not separated. As far as protocol is considered, FTP is using TCP protocol and TFTP is using UDP protocol. Port numbers 21 for control, 20 for data in case of FTP. And in case of TFTP, port number 3214, 69 and 4012 for operation. And data transfer, in FTP it is reliable one, in TFTP it is unreliable. In FTP, as far as number of connections, two connections are there. In TFTP, there is only one connection. And as far as commands are considered, in FTP there are many commands, but in TFTP limited, only 5 commands are present. Thank you. Now just we'll comment on anonymous facts about FTP. So anonymous FTP is enabled on some sites whose files are available for public access. A user can access these files without having any username or password. Instead, the username is set to anonymous and password to the guest by default. Here, user access is very limited. For example, the user can be allowed to copy the files but not to navigate through directories. So this is also one real-time fact as far as FTP is considered. Thank you.